Welcome back to Buildsome, and this is going to be presentation 8 in the series on the Australian Standard 1684.2, the Timber Framing Code. What you're looking at here is just a floor plan of the building that we're basing these programs on. And what I'm going to do in this video is just run through some preliminary calculations that you're going to need to do in order to work out the timber sizes for your roof. So first thing we need to work out is the half span of our building. So the overall width of our building in this case is 7.570, and what we can do with that is just divide it by 2 to get our half span. However, in this case, this building is a brick veneer building and it has a brick and a cavity on the outside, which is equal to 150 mil. So we have to make that deduction because the roof doesn't actually sit on the brickwork, it sits on the timber frame on the inside. So we have to take off our brick and our cavity. So width of the building divided by 2 minus your brick and your cavity will give us your half span, so 3.635 in this case. And then we want to work out the rise of the roof. So the formula for rise is tan, so the tan function on your calculator, by the roof pitch, which is going to be 30 degrees in this example, times by our half span. So tan 30 times 3.635 gives us 2.099. And then we also need to work out what we call the true length of the common rafter. So you can use Pythagoras using the half span and the rise. This is basically the hypotenuse of the triangle. But in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the half span, divide that by cos roof pitch, and that'll give me the same answer. So 3.635 divided by cos 30 roof pitch will give us 4.197. So I'll just show you how that looks. So we've got our half span, which is 3.635, our rise, which is 2.099, and our true length of common rafter at the moment, okay, from the centre line of our ridge to a line directly above the outside of the wall or the back of the bird's mouth, whichever you prefer, is 4.197. We also have to add on our overhang. So we still need to know what this distance here is. So we can take our eave overhang. Same situation. So eave overhang is the distance down the roof, not to be confused with your eave width, which is the horizontal distance out from the wall. So the plan says the eave width's 450. Remember, we have to add back on our 150 that we took off for our brick and our cavity. So that gives us 600 all up there. So 600 divided by cos 30 will give us a overhang of 0.693. So 0.693 there. So now we know those two distances, we can work out the RLW for this roof, the roof load width. So if you go back to the presentation I did on RLW, you'll know that if we take this span, because we have a purlin in the middle and it's not a strutted ridge, we take this span, divide that by 2, and add the overhang. So 4.197 divided by 2 gives us 2.098 plus our 0.693 gives us an RLW of 2.791. So you say, you could say 2.8. It'll just depend on what the next RLW available is in the span table. A couple other things we need to work out is the length of our inclined strut. So that's the strut running down here. So the way we do that is we imagine that this is a right angle triangle in here. We know that half our rafter is 2.098, and we know this is still 30 degrees, so we can just use it like use tan to work out this this side here. So 1030 by 2.098 gives us a inclined strut length of 1.211. So that's that there. And we may also need to know, just for plotting it onto a plan, a distance out from the wall where that's actually going to land. Because our purlin's in the centre of the roof, we need to know where that's going to land roughly. So what we can do again, we can use cos, and we know this distance here, so we can take 2.098, divide that by cos 30, and that'll tell us that that lands about 2.422 out from our wall plate. So we now know where that is. Other thing, if we had a straight strut, so a strut that came straight down, we obviously need to work out the length of that, and it'd also be good to know where that's going to land on a plan view as well. So in this case, we've got the reverse. This is our right angle down here. The only thing we actually know is this 2.098. So we can actually reverse our formula, if you like. So instead of dividing by cos and the roof pitch, this time we're going to multiply. So half our rafter times cos and the roof pitch. So 2.098 times cos 30 will give us 1.816. So that's the distance from there along the bottom of the triangle. So we get our plan distance. And now we know that distance, we can use tan to get the rise of this triangle. So tan 30 times 1.816 gives us a height of 1.049. So we now know that's the rise of the length that we would need for a straight strut. Okay, and all this will become apparent why we need it when we get into the span tables. So having a look at our struts, we just worked out what a straight strut length is. Okay, 1.211, so we know that. There may also be the situation where we need to work out a fan strut. So we need to know the length of a fan strut. These are commonly set at 45 degrees. So we can do the same thing that we did before with cos. So this time we're going to use 45. So 1.211 divided by cos 45 gives us a fan strut length of 1.713.